Hi there, welcome to the new episode of Skin and Hair Academy. So wouldn't it be great if you could bid a permanent goodbye to your waxing and shaving woes? Your monthly salon trips have taken too much of your time, and it's time we found a permanent solution to it. Nowadays, more and more women are going in for laser treatments, which are superior in effect and save you tons of money in the long run. So today, we have Dr. Jay Gupte, who's going to address some common questions regarding laser hair removal and skin resurfacing. Hi doctor, thank you for joining us
today.
Nice
to be here.
So let's start with some questions on laser hair removal. So what are the most prominent areas for laser hair removal?
See, to begin with, we need to clarify that it's not a hair removal. What we are doing is a permanent hair reduction. The point being, you cannot completely remove all the hair in a particular area. There's going to be some hair that stays back, some very thin hair that stays on. This cannot be completely removed, and that's why it's a small difference in terminology that we apply. It's hair reduction. Any client who wants to undergo hair reduction has to have this completely clear in their minds that it's never a removal, it's actually a reduction. Coming to your question, areas. You have the chin, you have the upper lip, and you have the side locks. Now, these are the most visible areas on a face. So they're easily targeted and the most frequently targeted. Other body areas, not so frequently, but they are done too.
So is it really painful?
See, the correlation stands in between the amount of thick hair in a particular area. So men with a thicker beard or women with thick hair in a particular area to be laced are going to feel a little more amount of pain as against thinner hair areas. Now, it's a common practice to use cooling gels or anesthetic creams or chill tips on machines to try to reduce the amount of pain that occurs. So we generally try to keep the patient as comfortable as possible during the procedure.
Oh, that sounds like a relief because it slightly sounds scary.
No, not much.
So are there any risks involved?
Well, like most procedures where lasers are done, active infections in a particular area, cardiac pacemakers, now these are big time no-nos. You just can't do it along with that. Still, with newer technologies, better machines, you just hardly have any amount of risk factors that are limited to laser hair reduction.
Wow, that sounds great. But how many sessions does an average hair removal process require?
See, generally you take about 6 to 12 sessions for an entire result to actually find itself being worthwhile looking at. But, you know, when you have good machines, you're done doing it for proper intervals, for you doing it for appropriate clients, you generally will get a good result. Just the time important is given.
Okay, sounds good. Well, that's a very encouraging answer. But how effective is laser hair removal on ingrown hair?
Yes, it is effective to a certain extent. You see, in ingrown hair, you have to have a combination treatment. Only hair reduction is not going to work. But a combination treatment will definitely give you a worthwhile good result.
Oh, it's a relief that is at least possible though. But what are the costs per session and do they vary based on the area being targeted?
Yes, they definitely vary depending on the amount of hair that is being done, where it is being done and where you are getting your job done. All of it is going to have different costs per se. But what is more important to know is that as long as you're doing it with the right people and you're doing it for a long enough period, you are definitely going to get good results. You should definitely ask your doctor if you have any extra creams that can be applied for getting a faster and a better result.
Okay, that's great. Thank you for the thorough introduction on laser hair reduction. Now moving on to laser resurfacing for the skin. So my first question is, what is the process like?
See, laser resurfacing of the skin basically tries to improve the texture of your skin.
Okay.
So it's going to try to work on small scars, small pores, basically tries to bring about a brightness to the face.
That sounds like a real problem solver. But how long does the effect of one session last?
Any resurfacing effect is going to last for almost up to 2 months, but there's going to be individual variation.
That's great. But are there any side effects to this process?
Not really. Mild pigmentation can stay on in after some procedure, but it's going to go away. So long-term side effects or big problems are not really known with laser resurfacing. As with every other laser procedure, no active infections at the site of the lasing should be present.
Well, that's great. But what should one do as a part of the aftercare?
Sun protection is the best thing to be done after any laser procedure, whether you do it with creams or whether you do it with gels or whether you do it with clothing. However, any procedure that your doctor has asked you to follow should always be done after every laser.
Okay, one should always follow doctor's instructions.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today, doctor. It was really helpful.
Thank you for having me. Sure.
So there you have it. I hope we were able to address all your queries. If you have any further questions, please mention in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Bye!